Paz v'yigash. The Torah tells us, as we mentioned Thursday night Shmuz, Yosef has finally ready to reveal himself. Yosef has held back for a while not to reveal himself to the kind of dreams. The dreams from the Mekuyim. A nice word this week of Simcha Scheinberg, the Yeshiva of beautiful word. He said that it says by Yaakov Avinu, says that he was waiting. Shama Avu Shoresma by the dreams. Avu Shoresma Dov. He was waiting at the dreams from Mekuyim. What's the pshat? He was waiting the dreams from Mekuyim. So he said a beautiful word. He said that Simcha, word from Simcha. Son was spoken to Shulis. He said, "Oh, the law, very nice boy." He said that it says, "So the Maisi said that the Medrash says that when Yaakov Rachel came and said, listen, Rachel came to Yaakov and said, I don't have children. I'm Esau Noichi, she said. So he said, what do you want from me? I have kids. So the Mishnah brings this magic, famous magic. This is how you answer people who are in distress. So the tikkun for Yaakov Avinu's chet of Kachmas and Manuka was what? That they had to bow to him. And if they be not, but Mela, for all of Shomer's had to offer, he was waiting to Mekuyim, because that would be a kapara for him. He had to get a kapara of eventually, but not all of they be not. Nice word, no? It's amazing. So Mela, So Yaakov Avinu was Shomer. So though he's waiting with this kapara, this tikkun should happen. The male was waiting that dream should be sky. But when the dreams were sky, now Binyamin came to bow for him. So that was ready. He was oimed to reveal himself. Maybe he would have waited a little bit longer. It says because maybe the kaim some hold he wanted to kaim the dream in its fullest. But Yaakov Avinu, but the ma'aser b'ischazik Yisrael. Maybe that was the sky. This week's parsha. But anyway, we came to the matzav. Yosef is now ready. He revealed himself, but not only to reveal himself, as we said in the Thursday, was he had an idiot to give him teichacha. They needed to get teichacha. They had made a terrible mistake. They had sold their brother for a pair of shoes. And they now have to realize the terrible mistake that it came from whatever reason why they did it, or jealousy, whatever it was. But it was a wrong thing, and they made a terrible mistake. So Yosef wants to give the punchline on Yosef. He wants to tell his brothers, Ani Yosef. He's been waiting for a long time to tell his brother, Ani Yosef. And according to me, he wants to tell him, Ha'oid Avichai. Ha'oid Avichai. Of a state in Pasik, V'lo Yochol Yosef, this apek. V'chal Yitzom Olof. Yosef cannot hold back, V'chal Yitzom Olof. V'yikra. Ho'itzio Cholish Me'olai. V'lo Omar Isha Yitroi B'svada Yosef, V'lecho Mo'yedik Apasik Apoisa. The Yosef Atzalik and Rashi touched the Pasik. He could not fathom, he couldn't bear. She Mitzrayim, Mitzavim Olav, Mitzrayim, Mitzrayim, Sheechim, Mitzvayim, Shemim, Yvodim, Lahem. Unbelievable thing about Yosef. Hear what's going on over here, but I hear the godless. Admosi, Agiu, Masa, Adamasa, Avoisa, but this Rashi is should have must mamish we saw at this point we all know the Rashi. We should have mamish had such an unbelievable chizuk, but an unbelievable look at the Madrega what Yosef Atzalga was. Yosef standing here, he was really mamish badgered. They took him as a young kid, and he was asking us, Achan, I want my brothers. He wanted brotherhood, and he was interested in brotherhood. And they took him, and they not only threw, first they wanted to kill him, and they threw him into a pit with snakes and scorpions. And they took him out, Father, they ripped him out of the pit and sold him to a bunch of Arabs on the way down. Smelly Arabs, but this time they happened to have a good smell, Hashem Baruch Hashem. With no deodorant, but they were carrying still good stuff. But anyway, no old spice, new spice. Whatever it was, Lamaiz Shavishal Dava, they throw him to the Arabs and begun him. And then he gets sold down to Mitzrayim, the place, that place of Mamish, Hashem Yirachim. He has to go through what it is, Ashes Potiphar, and be in jail, and all the sorrows of Moses. Can you imagine what's going through Yosef's mind now? Oh, how sweet is revenge, man. How sweet is revenge! This is the opportunity I've been waiting for! I can Mamish get them now! They made my life bitter! Obviously Hashem had better plans, but they destroyed my life. They took away from my father, Avichai, 22 years. Yosef was in love with his father. He had a tremendous relationship with his father. And he had to be down in the tribe for 22 years. And here comes the punchline. He's all ready. And he can't hold back. He can't hold back anymore. According to somebody, he wanted to hold back more. The Yaakov should come down. Maybe he can't. It's not now. He's bursting. At this moment, Rabbi Yisrael, what would the normal person be going? Just let it out, man. Let it out! All the psychologists will tell you, you gotta let it out. So let it out! Burst it out! Get it out of your chest already, Joe! Get it off! Lo yochol Yosef, that's unbelievable, godless, kodos ha-nefesh, Rabbi Yisrael. He can't hold back. Why? He has to get everybody out of the room. Why? So they shouldn't be shamed. They shouldn't be shamed. They shouldn't have busha from the Mitzrayim. They'll have busha bad, so of course they're going to have busha. They're going to have Shmuez busha. This busha wasn't that, then the Shamas went out for the busha. But so they'll have an extra busha to be in front of the Mitzrayim. They don't deserve that busha pasha. Yosef Paskin, that the busha of knowing Ani Yosef and the criticism that to know that they have to be criticized and given toichocha, that anoid avichai, that your tiny of the base of Levi is a shtus. Oid avichai, where's your all concern and care when you sold me down here? It's shtus for hevel. The tiny is up the schlacht. Mamish mineu bay. But mitzad sheini, they don't deserve that extra busha from the Jimitzvah. That they don't deserve. They don't deserve it. They don't, and if Yosef felt maybe they did, but he didn't want them to have the extra busha. The godless ha-nefesh of a person understanding that you have to criticize sometimes. And you have to criticize, and you have to tell somebody when he's doing something wrong. And you have to give it over to the guy very strongly that he knows. But at the same time, to have the gedult and have the understanding and the righteousness to know that to make it much more painful for the guy than it has to be. And we see Vayitu, Rabbi Yisrael, Nochak Nature. After this tremendous thing, Rabbi Yisrael, this tremendous busha, this tremendous thing, Yosef gave it to them. And he gave it to them good, Rabbi Yisrael. They were staring there with their mouths wide, the jaw dropped 10 feet. And they were staring with their mouth open like mamish, like a bombshell hit, Hiroshima. Yosef standing there, you know, he could have Mamish, you know, taken the screwdriver and went deeper. Gone deeper with it. You guys sold me down here, look what happened. What happens right after that? But Yosef, Kishuno Eila, Rei Goshu. Rashi says, Lashon Tachnunim, Lashon Raka. You heard what you had to hear. You got your Musa, Beis Halevi, this Torah, that Torah. They got exactly what they had to hear. Now, he hugs them, he kisses them. Why? This showed Rabbi Yisrael that it was after one thing over here. It wasn't revenge, and it wasn't to try to hurt them, get them. He could have done it many. It was one thing. They had to know that they did was wrong. But more than that, extra busha, how it's supposed to be, Rabbi, this is an unbelievable Musar lesson. It's a sheer klali. It had a gift to Chacha. Because this was the moment they needed the most to Chacha. This wasn't Stamba Toy Chacha. Oh, you come a little Shbet to Shachris, the Mashkiach pulls you in. You know, you're coming a little late to Shachris. You miss Shachris, this, you're not so, you know, this, that. This was a Matoy Chacha they were living a false life. They were living in a dream. They were living in a mistake, in a sheker. And Yosef had to correct that mistake. Yosef had to correct it in the most deepest way. There was a tifa mistake or a terrible mistake. The mistake was so deep that they couldn't even notice it was Yosef. One of the biggest powers of different shmuzer boys said, this is the most powerful because no one has answered this question. Yosef is sitting there. So the answer of the Gemara is without the answer. He left without a beard, and now he has a beard. Pella the Gemara by saying, Tzorach Iyin Gogo, Chas B'Shol, Chazal said, we have to understand it. Well, maybe we'll touch it over, but it's the Chorah Pella by saying, Chazal said that Yosef looked exactly like Yaakov. I have a question. Did Yaakov have a beard? I don't think he was clean shaved. He was the, you know, rabbi for the young Israel. He didn't have a, Yaakov even had a beard, the Chorah. So he looked even more like Yaakov Avinu. And he doesn't look Egyptian, by saying. No mummies. He looked like a Jewish guy with a big nose. And he, oh, well, who could that be? And he starts telling you, Reuven, Shimon, and Yuli, and your cradle used to have a little thing that used to play. Na 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 na. Kids, you had this, you had that. He was going through this. See, you know, he was telling them everything about everything the boy said. And they're not with him for this 5 minutes. They got a glance at his side. The side of his neck, they got a glance. They're sitting in front of eating with him. The whole time he's telling them, I don't still know how to meet him, that it's him. Pella the Gazaka, boy, he said, how could it be? How could it be? It's not like one of the most clear Aksumi, but you see, it's Murray the Gazama, it's commercial for a different Shemuel, boy, he said. I always say the Pshad Rashi says that they came down, they came, so you say, okay, they weren't looking for Yosef. They thought he was dead. They thought he was in the cavern. Rashi says, by Yerodu Achi Yosef, they were looking for him. They're looking for him in the corner, for Dika's Chometz. Maybe he's in there, in between the cracks. And a man standing in front of them, and he's speaking to them. He looks like Yosef. He acts like Yosef. He tells them everything. Wow, who could that be? Three choices, none of the above. Hell of the Gazaga, Yosef. The Terence of Rashi says they were looking for the Eved, Yosef. The Poydim Mekom Mokum Shehu. They're looking for the Eved. There's no such Metzias as Yosef Amel. Can't be. It was out of their thing. This guy cannot be. So who could it be? Maybe it's the guy down the block, cleaning the streets, the plumber, Joe's plumbing. Maybe he's to open the plumbing business, but he's not standing there as a king. That out of our vocabulary is not the shot. It's out of the picture. They were looking for Eved. The Poydim Mekom Mokum. They ready to spend a lot of money because they said he's the Eved. It's not, he's only an Eved. It's not Shav. You're not an Eved. The kids are different shmooz that a person doesn't want to see, he won't see no matter how much you show in front of him. But here, he saw there was a makom now to get them and give them the tochach that they needed to hear that the whole derech ha-chayim, the whole machshava, it's a tois me'ikarim. So he has to give them real tochach. He says the words that he has to say, nothing more, nothing less. He doesn't add. He doesn't go into it more. I mean, Yosef, that's all he needs to say. That's it. It speaks for itself. Now they got the Tochach of Yosef, saw it affected it. That's it, Rabbi Yisrael. The criticism is over. They got the message. They understand. So first of all, he doesn't do it in a shameful way. They should be embarrassed. That's you don't give to the Tochach. You don't scream at a person in front of the whole world. But even when he does it, Rabbi Yisrael, at the end, after the Tochach is over, Yosef showed him this total Hashem Shemayim, Shuno Eli, and he starts hugging them and kissing them and everything. Why was totally Hashem Shemayim? You have to know the Vart. You have to, you did something wrong, and now I love you, I care about you, and this is the most important voice. This is a Musa and Hasid. This could be the Pshat. The Pasha Tad, the Chaznish says we can't give Techacha today. It's very hard to give Techacha. We don't know how to give Techacha. People don't understand that even if you have to give Techacha, you have to think many times what's going on by Yanim. And you have to something correct, and you have to criticize. And let's call you have to try to correct and you want to help and a good friend wants to give a person to Chacha. Don't let him do whatever he wants. You see a guy do something wrong, you go over and you tell him something because you really care about him. The friend who doesn't care, that's the guy who just lets the guy go and go to the Shem Yishra and blow himself up. But a guy who cares about it doesn't let him go into the minefield. He tells him, he tries to tell him maybe not to hang out with these guys. He tries to warn him from difficult and dangerous people. That's a real friend, as Mr. Yosheshon. The friends were saying, oh, you're doing a great job. Go, you know, sleep all day, whatever. Ah, Givalda, keep it going. You're saying the Guinness Book World Records. Keep it going. You'll be famous one day. How many hours you slept in Yeshiva? They'll have your picture up in the Guinness Book of World Records. 364 days. He doesn't want to suck in the cartridge. Kitzo. Okay, so he doesn't let him sleep. He goes to him and tries to win. But the boy said, how to give to, how to criticize the boy said, how to criticize, how to tell somebody that you care about him really and give it the right way, the boy said. This is so important in life, the boy said, because we have this so often. And the most important time, the boy said, is but even more, the boy said, we get always get down to this. I've been paid by the women to speak about it. No, but kids, but the Yisroel Apelbaum is marriage, the boy said. How to criticize a person sometimes has to, and he will, in his marriage, have to say a few words. He can't eat chicken wings every single night. Just doesn't go. He's gonna be, next time he sees a chicken wing, he's gonna fly out the wing with on the wings of the chicken. He can't see another chicken wing, Rabbi said. We have to know how to do it, Rabbi said. We have to know how to do it, when to do it. It's the right way, Rabbi said. If he doesn't have to do it, he's on that Madrega or Moshe Feinstein. Everybody knows the story of Moshe. Page 57, 17 lines to the top. Moshe was the Rav of Lubav at age 20. He became the Rav of Lubav. And Maisa, he was a single guy. And they had somebody cook for him. He didn't have a wife yet. He only got married to the Rebbetzin a year later, a few years later. He was 25 when Moshe got married. 27 maybe. 27 Moshe got married. So the Maisa, yeah, they were married for 64 years, 91. Kitta, so he got married at 27, so I from 20 to 27 is above, but then he was the Rav in Uzda. He was the Rav in Uzda for him. Lubam was later, then he was mad. And Uzdi was the Rav. So it was Uzdi was the Rav, and he had a Mavashele, a lady cooked for him. And she cooked for him meals. And his sister, Rebetzin Chana Small, Chana Katz, Chana Small came to visit him, which was Chana Feinstein there. And she said, Moshe, you look like you're putting on weight these days. You're getting a little heavy, maybe your frock is a little tight on you. So he said, yeah, well, Baruch Hashem, the lady makes me food. She fills up my plate with a heavy, heaping portion of food, you know, mashed, whatever it is. It's very hard to tell. I said, what's your McCoy? It's very hard to decipher what it is. But anyway, she fills the plate with this huge concoction. Bananas and string beans, whatever, everything. She found the kitchen, throws it into the... Anyway, she fills the plate, and I eat it, and I finish the whole plate. And then she sees it's empty, she says, he must be hungry, she fills it again. And he said, so she said to the kids, so she joined him for lunch. Oh boy, did she regret that back then. So she got also a heaping portion. She said she took one bite, and she thought she was going to throw up. She quickly found a dog, something, she quickly got it off her plate somehow. And she had, and Moshe for 3 years was eating this food straight because he didn't want to say anything. She was cursed, I told her that. But we're not on that Madrega because we call it a heaping portion of what she McCall. We don't know what it is, where she dug it up. And Moshe, you have to say something, Moshe. But Moshe, how to say something, Moshe. The wife worked the whole day on this concoction. I don't know how she was able to work the whole day on this thing, Moshe, because you have to be a genius. To... Anyway, the kids are... But you work the whole day on it, and you come home, and the boy said, and it tastes like... I don't want to say what it tastes like. It's not the most enticing thing, the boy said. So what do you do now, the boy said? You have to know how to criticize, and the mice, your wife spent... You see the sweat, perspiration coming down the sides of her head. She was hitting the hot kitchen. And you were in the air-conditioned base medrash, back to Shmuez 21, you still didn't buy the air conditioner. But anyway, Rabbeisa, at the end of the day, so what do you do, Rabbeisa? You have to know, Rabbeisa, we have to be so careful, a person's feelings, we're not malochim, but we have to understand the Torah expects us to understand that even we have to say something, we have to give over something Christian, something that we might not like, it has to be so soft and so right and so careful that we care about the other, not to cause them anything bad. First of all, Hotzil Kol Ish Me'olai. If you don't like the food, this food, you know, in front of the whole family. If you want to say the food's no good, Hotzil Kol Ish Me'olai. like Yosef, first get everybody out of the room. Kids don't have to, this kid is young, he doesn't know what's good or what's bad. Let him eat the food. But Hotzia Kolish may honor, you know, I have to be careful. If I eat too much of these types of potatoes, that starch is not so good for me. I need more. The kids, you come with a mahalo, but it has to be with gloves to understand how to talk to a wife. You're upset, you're careful. But boy, is that hurting someone's feelings? Is something that the Bein Shom is Teveya, very stark, what they say. Very stark. We have to be so careful. So even when we have to, we have a right. Yosef had all the right in the world. But see how careful he went. Adas soiv, nothing extra, no extra shame from the mitzvim. And afterwards it's finished, right back to the love, right back to the care. Sometimes a guy gives criticism to a guy, he bears a grudge for 3 weeks, the boy said. You know, there's a way of doing things, the boy said. There's a way of telling somebody off. There's a way, even of throwing somebody out of yeshiva, there's a way of doing that. A guy could feel the boy said, that the Vaisa Sovishal Dova, there's people they throw out of the yeshiva, they feel like garbage, and they ruin their whole life. And a person could do it in a way where he feels the guy's a mensch. It says Steinman worked very hard never to throw out a bacha. But he said, even when he threw it out, the three times he threw it, he always made sure he found him a place. And he got him a place to go, and it was done with loving care. The bacha never had to, he had, obviously, there's always going to be some type of thing, but Sovishal Dova, the bacha didn't take it so bad, because it's a different story. When you know that it's really coming from care, that you love the person, you care a person, it's just a matter, you can't afford, you can't deal with it. This is the lesson we learned, the Musa Shmuz, the Sheikh Klali from Yosef HaTzadik, in the mitzvah of Teichacha, that when you have to give it as short as possible, you're careful which words you have to say. Oh, you only Yosef, that was enough, you didn't need more. And beforehand, not to cause any extra shame, and afterwards, with the love and back, and kissing them, and hugging them, that I really care for you. If it's done that way, it was a chutz from the fact that you're Yoytzi mitzvah Teichacha, and you're doing the right thing by her, but the Maestro of Teichacha has much greater effect. We see by Yankov, one Yankov Avinu says, by Yankov Avinu, he came to the well, Achai, man, Boson, and Yankov Kepnesi says, he came to the well, he asked, we called him a brother, he didn't know them, he first got a good feeling with them, he made them feel good, then he gave it to Chokh, but he said, this is the lesson, this is the Musa Shmuz, to be Zoycha, to be able to have a good relationship with the people, and to realize that we think about their feelings, even when it comes a moment that I'm right, and I have to criticize, and I have to make a moment, it has to be done with gloves, with care and understanding, not to hurt the person. Mizrachu through that, Rabbi Yisrael, but though it's been mentioned that the today tonight is Asar B'Tavis. Asar B'Tavis is the Aschola of Ujraham. Everybody says it's the Aschola. It's much worse of the four Tanaisim because it's the Aschola. Everything goes much to the Aschola. That's why some hold that Ujraham holds if it comes out on Shabbos, if he has on Shabbos. But the Pshat is about it. The Tikkun is from tonight also. The Tikkun is from tonight. If the aschov of the churban was tonight, the tikkun is from tonight, and the churban we know it's from Beshir Sheni was because of Sinas Chinam, because we didn't know how to get along with people. But the way to misaken that is avas chinam, is to love everybody, to treat everybody carefully, and even we have to criticize with gloves, with our caring and understanding. We zirch of you that the bini bayis a shlishi mehem.